You think say you sabi Naija music? Old school or new school? Come show yourself for Gusto Gets the Song. You go win better, better. Call the number where they appear for your screen. So, Naija music, come win money.
Guys, welcome to Gusto Reactions once again. Thank you so much for liking, sharing, subscribing. Of course, telling your friends, please, if you're watching for the first time, please do well to like this video. Also, share this video. Also, post this video anywhere. You can support us by also subscribing to the channel. We love and appreciate all of you. You guys are actually the best. And we really, really appreciate you for everything that you do for us. Big Lala is very much in the building today. Yes. I'd like to ask, you could actually get some money from this. But when you think about Mayanna, when you hear the word Mayanna, what's the first thing that comes to you? Or what is that word most popular for?
Something Mayanna. Mayanna. What's it popular for?
You have 5 seconds.
Each one be a 5 seconds.
1, 2, 3, 4.
I never
even bought. Anyways.
Wait. Mayanna.
So it actually, wait, calm down now so that we can move on with this show.
Oh yeah, I'm here. This
is Dodo Mayanna.
Who's Dodo Mayanna?
Peter Rufai.
Nah, that's a lie. Peter Rufai has nothing to do with being called Mayanna.
Dodo Mayanna?
No. Peter Rufai has nothing to be called
Dodo Mayanna.
The only thing that people call Peter Rufai for is either calling Keeper Rufai.
No.
Or Peter Rufai.
No. Check your phone. Dodo Mayanna, Peter Rufai. 1994 World Cup.
Are you joking? If you know,
I give you 100k.
Dodo Mayanna.
Yes, Dodo Mayanna. Peter Rufai. Dodo Mayanna, Peter Rufai. Ah, that's his nickname. Come on.
The only Dodo Mayanna here is a song by someone called Bizouch.
No. Dodo Mayanna, Peter Rufai. Have you seen it?
I'm not saying.
I should have said you pay your money if you saw it. Anyways, we're here today because of Asha, guys. That was just like, you know, by the way. Today, Asha, of course. Chicken, I mean, cockerel, I mean, whatever it is. Anyways, Asha has been, you know, she's been quite, you know, in the game for a while, over 10 years.
Yes.
And of course, we know the Lucid album, actually. Mm-hmm. Quite a couple of dope songs on there.
Mm-hmm.
Were you surprised when you saw Asha in the studio with P-Prime the first time?
Yeah, of course, it was surprising because P-Prime hasn't shown himself to be that kind of producer who could produce for people like Asha.
Asha, yeah.
You know, he's more of a hit maker or hit making producer in terms of fast paced, mid tempo, level jams. But this just shows his versatility. And I'm proud of his effort so far.
Exactly. And of course, she's also appeared, you know, with Files, with Ward as well.
Yeah.
And you think, okay, maybe Asha and Ward, of course, you wouldn't be surprised. Mm-hmm. With the Cavemen as well, you know, Asha has done quite, you know. And just some days ago, the result of that P-Prime meeting resulted in Asha's new single, Mayanna. Mayanna. Now, for Asha, the song Mayanna, what exactly would have come to your head if you had not listened to
it? Well, I would have thought the first thing Asha was going to go the route of maybe trying to do an Afro pop record or Afro beats record per se. But that was the first thing that came to my mind. But then listening to the song, it's not the usual Asha, it's different.
Yeah.
Because P-Prime, in as much as we know that he's the fast wave producer, was able to do a mid-tempo production on this. And Asha had to just blend in. And give us some. I mean, the instrumental of that song sounded like something Wiz or any of these other artists want to jump on that they would like. But here we are, it's Asha on it, and she was able to deliver nicely. And it's not the first time Asha would be on the mid-tempo jam. She's done that. She's been there. She's done that. But we know where her strong suits are. But on this, you could not even tell that. Oh, is this the Asha that is always giving us slow ballads and songs and everything? I mean, she did really well.
So would you say that Asha, you know, with Mayanna, has unlocked a new level?
Not particularly a new level, but I think what she's trying to do is she's trying to appeal more to the much younger or newer audience. Majority of Asha fans, they're from way back. They're not from right now. I mean, if people are shouting and screaming Asha right now, the new generation of people will be like, yeah, who is she? What she done? You get.
She done
they don't know what her greatness is like. They didn't witness it. You get. So Now, this attempt is to appeal more to that audience. She didn't have to do her usual slow ballad kind of music. She was able to flow with the mid-tempo beats and also deliver, like, this is what they would call an Afro-fusion kind of song. That's what she's just delivered.
Okay, but you know, Asha is quite popular, you know, in the Francophone, French, you know, speaking countries and everything. She goes to France and kill the shows. Will the Mayana song do well in France?
Well, without the Mayana, she has other songs that does, I mean, that people do like, that she performs when she goes on these shows. Mayana is a new song. I wouldn't expect it to be the groundbreaking or the hits that she currently has. Nah, I mean, all her best works so far has been what she's done before. So now, Mayana will just be one of those newer tracks she's trying to introduce to even our old fans, because our old fans may not be used to things like this.
So you think this is Afrobeat or Afrofusion?
I think this is Afrofusion. The instrumental is very similar to something. I just can't place my head around it, but it's very recent. The production is recent. The style, everything about it is just recent. All thanks to P-Prime. And that would, I mean, get more people interested, get more young fans interested.
So would you say Anasha and P-Prime chemistry is something that we could actually look forward to?
I don't think for long time, because she can't decide to completely switch and start doing songs like Mayana. I mean, this would be a one-off for Asha. I think her strong suit would still be those kind of songs she used to do before. You get, but once in a while when she dropped things like this, of course, when P-Prime is available, superb production, by the way.
Okay, let's go to the video, you know, directed by Meji, you know, Alabi. This actually, looking at the video, you know, since it was shot in Ghana, does it match up with the song?
Well, video was simple and yet intriguing. Seeing Asha dressed the way she is, not every time you see her dressed like that. She was groovy, she was moving. And then the dancer guy was really, really nice. I mean, the focus was mainly on him, but he was dancing well and he was energetic. And then, this was a funny scene.
Actually.
And the young boy too was also dancing.
Oh, the whole really well. Backflip and everything.
I really enjoyed watching. I mean, it gives me vibes of Burna Boy's Dangote. There's focus on one particular character, which is a dancer, and he was delivering well. Asha was just coming in and out and doing her thing. So it wasn't, it was simple. There was nothing too over the top. And it was majority of it were night scenes.
For me, it gave me the whole Olamide, you know, rock kind of thing. The lady just moving and around, switching and everything.
That works too.
I mean, that was really too. And Whiskey's Joro as well.
Yeah, that you works know? Too.
Yeah. So yeah, the video, the song itself, Asha, Mayana, what exactly do you think hit or miss?
I think this is a dope song. I think it's a dope song. Really, really do well in Nigeria, knowing the kind of music people love. I don't think so, but I think people will appreciate Asha's comeback and this sort of songs.
Yeah.
I've not seen anybody who has a problem with this song.
Yeah.
I think it's a dope jam. In the sense of a word hit in the Nigerian context, maybe not, but it's a very good song.
Okay, let's have your thoughts on that one, Asha. With that one, Mayana. Mind you, Lala missed, you know, the quiz. He would have gotten 100,000 naira, but he missed that.
Be giving me this quiz every time. Be giving me this quiz every time.
But you know, I will come like a thief in the night. You don't go nowhere. I go just show say.
You be thief for money at night.
Someone was asking me that I didn't buy tickets for you.
I miss. There's record there.
Don't worry, guys. I've got tickets for Big Lala if he's ready to go out at 11 p.m., 12 midnight to a couple of these shows in Lagos this December. I've got tickets for Big Lala. Let Big Lala say it right here that he's ready to go out.
Why must I say it? I can tell you. I can WhatsApp you and tell you. I need tickets for this and you provide it.
No. You have to commit to it before I make it available.
No problem.
You know, quickly talk now. Why no? We'll see you guys on the next one. Let's have your thoughts. Asha, Mayana, produced by P-Prime, video directed by Meji Alabi. Let's have your thoughts. Hit or miss, put them down below. We'll see you on the next one. Peace.